Hello friends. I will teach you how to make the character cry in this tutorial. As you can see, I have a character that has a bone layer and there are other layers inside this layer. I want to create tears for this character. I create a new vector layer and name this layer tears. By dragging this tear layer, I place it inside the bone layer and above the head folder. I zoom in a bit and create a tear path with the freehand tool. I adjust the points with the transform tool. I delete the extra points. With the line width tool and dragging, I make the line thickness of some points less and others more. I adjust the points again with the transform tool. Now I put the slider in frame 1. Auto freeze keys must be active. With the transform tool, I left click on the tier so that all points are selected. In this way, keyframes are created in frame 1. I select the stroke exposure tool and set the end percentage to 0 and left click. Now you see that the path of tears is hidden. I put the slider at frame 24 and click again on the tear path to create keyframes. And I change the end percentage number and set it to 0 again and left click to create the last keyframe. In this way, there is no change from frames 0 to 24. I put the slider at frame 48 and set the end percentage to 27 so that we can see some tears. I put the slider in frame 72 and increase the end percentage and start percentage. I put the slider in frame 96 and set the end percentage to 100 and the start percentage to 100. I press the play button to see the animation. I put the slider at frame 0 and change the color of the tears with the select shape tool. And I reduce its opacity. We have to create tears for the other eye. I select the origin tool and left click on the tear. Now I select the transform tool and make a duplicate of the teardrop layer. I adjust its location and make it smaller and reverse the direction of the tear layer with the flip tool. So that the animation of the tears is not similar, I select all the keyframes of the tier layer 2 and drag them by holding the Alt button to reduce the distance between the keyframes. Now if I play, you will see the change. I can create the cycle mode for repeating the animation. Now I press the play button to see the result. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.